Well, hello, dear associates, and welcome back to another shift on Space Station 13. Tonight, we have been assigned to Port 17. Mission, round, shift, whatever, already in progress by just like 30 seconds. Let's see, what do we have? We could be a research director. I still don't know very much about research, though, so I will not take a director position. Detective could be kind of fun. I don't really feel like busting heads, though. Roboticist, miner. You know, let's actually be an engineer. I have not even bothered to look at the engine. Well, I've looked at the engine, but I've not actually messed with it. I haven't turned any valves, messed with any canisters, or flipped any switches, if it even has any of those. But today we are at least going to be watching people who might know what they're doing as they screw around with the engine and kill us all. Should be fun. So, get dressed in here. I would suggest always keeping a fire suit on you from what I've seen. As well as a gas mask. I'll put a hard hat on. Get rid of my PDA. Gotta get suited up for the job here. Of course I want a utility belt, because I'm gonna be losing my backpack. I will be replacing that with one of these blue canisters here. No, I don't want to weld. Because you never know when a leak is gonna happen in the engine. Be it a CO2 leak, a plasma leak. You know, these things happen. And that's the last thing you want to be breathing in or getting a lung full of. I'll take a multi-tool. Might as well. And a T-ray scanner. Even though I don't think they have any use with this engine at all. I could be wrong. Don't even need to adjust the pressure on these tanks, I'm pretty sure. And you know, I'll just drop the backpack right there for now. But hell, I'll put my fire suit on. You do move just a little bit slower with it. But, not too bad. So yeah, there is furnace fuel, which is ore. And, you can start the furnaces until you have the engine ready to go. CO2... Into, he's probably eyeballing me like, who is that strange guy stumbling around my death engine? Just a tourist. 495. Pressure's already rising in there. So he's got the tanks attached to that. Or he did, but he's moving them. 510. So you move the plasma to this port. Let's see, some of these might be labeled too. Meter, vacuum, combustion chamber, port 1, port 2. I'm gonna guess that port 1 takes oxygen. You mix oxygen and toxins, plasma, into the engine and then ignite it. Plasma has to have oxygen to burn hot. Yep. And there's the tank. So, as far as what goes on in here, I have no idea. 503, that's slowly raising. I think that these furnaces can boost the pressure even more. Is the heat increasing? Pressure is... Except here, the pressure is, so I'm pretty sure that means the heat must be. You can't get more pressure without more heat, I'm pretty damn sure. Over here we've got another plasma canister turned on. You can see this valve is green, this one is red. Again, I don't know how well these little itty-bitty pixels will show up on YouTube. 3.4. 3.3. Are the hot loop pumps turned on? This is the cold loop side that we're on. I'm not entirely sure how it works. But you got cold and hot. And they work together to power the station and kill people. So that's 80. And he ignites it. And there we go. We have fire! Who put plasma in the hot loop? Not me, because I don't even know what the fuck I'm doing. And I'm not pressing buttons my first day in engineering. Well, rest in peace, Mr. Rathen. Apparently Bryson did. So, you can put plasma or CO2, but he says plasma is better in the hot loop. Wait a second. Analyzer. Can I analyze these things? Yep. 100% plasma in this pipe. 100% plasma in this one. 100% oxygen in that one. So what comes out over here? I can't actually scan that. What about this pipe? That's 100% plasma still. Plasma. Are both of these plasma? Well, where's... Maybe the oxygen's being completely consumed by the fire. But that should be leaving CO2 to be pumped out somewhere, right? Or another gas... 531, quickly rising in temperature, 535. So you can only scan the red pipes. That's got plasma 19 degrees Celsius. Negative 251, that's 100% plasma. All I'm finding is plasma everywhere. Plasma, plasma, plasma. Why do I have a horrible feeling that this engine is just gonna end with a horrible plasma fire? The pipe is empty because it's sealed right here, so nothing's actually being vented to it. But plasma is being vented up to these two points here, where it's still sealed off. Someone has their pod. Oh goody, we've got visitors. Oh goody, visitors. And negative 129, negative 130. What's the pressure? 218. So yeah, I have no idea what's going on. Let's go check out this machine right here that makes all types of weird noises. Does anything happen? Can't analyze it. So let's see the output. 1.3 megawatts. Temperature inlet. Cold loop here. You can see these numbers. They don't mean anything to me. Not bad. It was a good game. Did they already kill the captain? I really hope they didn't kill the captain yet. I've not spent nearly enough time with this engine. Wow, that dropped our power a lot. See, it's not very stable, the power. It seems to bounce around a lot. It's awfully hot. How hot? Awfully hot for the cold loop? What is its temperature? 146 Kelvin? I have no idea what that actually relates to. Kelvin? What's that in Fahrenheit? I understand that. 90 degrees Celsius. Yeah, it is. Maybe plasma was not a good idea. I I'm gonna go over there and say that. Maybe pure plasma was a bad idea in the cold loop? Negative 100°C. Negative 96°C. I think that got the temperature back down. Negative 89. It's warming up pretty damn quick. That's a good sign. That's not a good... I don't remember seeing that in the book anywhere. The generator erupts in flames. Negative 80°C. I guess that is normal. That went right for him. Who used to be standing there? Did someone get ashed? I don't think it shocks that much. It caught the paper on fire. This thing sounds like it's coming alive. Negative 71. I'm not sure how cold the cold loop is supposed to be. That's pretty much my big problem. Negative 68. So what about this? How hot is this side getting? 923 degrees Celsius. Closed? Why are those shutters closed? Maybe it was gonna break through or something? I have no idea if it can get so hot that it will actually melt the glass or anything. 910 degrees Celsius. So it's just kind of hovering around 890. Starting to cool down. 880. Yeah, we're losing temp pretty quick here. Negative 64. Takes a bit of maintenance, and I don't know exactly what the hell we're supposed to do to maintain it. Put more canisters in, by chance? I wish I was more helpful here, but temp still dropping, output's 1.2 megawatts. I guess the cold loop is fine for now. Engine output, 1.2 megawatts. Brilliant. The SMEs are drawing not even about a third of that. I'll drop the cold loop pump settings, whatever that means. Looks like the cells, all of the APCs were starting to drain. Are these not ramped high enough? Let's see, output is 70. Output, load. What happens if I put more output over here? That goes to 80. That goes to 10. Okay. I'm going to kind of balance out the load between these two units. That's 40,000, 50,000. And the syndicates actually did win. Well, damn you, syndicates. And, horrible job, Captain. I don't know about the rest of the crew, but I thought the engineers were doing kinda good.
Well,
I guess that's it, guys. What one hell of a short shift. I will see you guys next time I work.
You want to put a banging donk on it?
Which will probably be a few days. Well, hello, fellow associates, and welcome back to another shift on Space Station 13. We are on Star Outpost 48 today. I am going to ready up, maybe, possibly, hopefully, perhaps get a trader role, and still going to be working in the kitchen, most likely. Either as the chef or the barman. Going to be a pretty slow round. It's late, I'm tired, and we're the barman. Question is, are we a traitor barman? Probably not. Where's my notes? I always have to check my notes, because sometimes you'll be a traitor and it won't pop up. So no, I'm not. I'm also Dallas Powers. And I guess I'll wear a top hat, considering the fact I'm going bald. Also, for the most part, this is going to be a non-alcoholic bar. I will only be serving sugary, sweet drinks, like triple citrus lemonade that everybody loves. Actually, I will be serving, again, it's not going to be completely alcohol-free. I will have shots of things. Also, get that, some half and half and lemonade. Not nearly as sweet and as strong as the triple twist lemonade there. And one shot of bourbon, primarily for, you know, people like the captain. They want to come in and have a little shot without having to worry about getting completely drunk. Also, I adjusted my mic there. If there was some really loud sound that I forget to edit out, apologies for the ear rape. Is the chef already eating? He is. Caden Parkinson. Where's the food, chef? And apparently there's already been a changeling spotted. Great, the chef is going to eat all of the food. And an Arnold Palmer, if I can pronounce it. There we go. Drink up, lads. It's all alcohol free. And his mouth puckers up from the flavor. Pretty good stuff, huh? Oh, and the chef is murdering Remy, too. Oh well. I hate that damn rat. The rat is suicidal anyways. I'm pretty sure he'll purposefully jump under your knife just to be put out of his misery. Let's see, what else can I make? I don't think I know all of the recipes, but so let's see, we've got lemonade, of course. Half and half. And triple citrus. That's really it. That's pretty much all of the non-alcoholic drinks I know how to miss. I was hoping for like cherry coke. Things like that. Cherry cola or something. Because you've got cherry juice, but Mr. K-Cat. Thirsty for anything by chance? No problem, Doug. He's had his fill. So he steps out. Let's see, get me a surprise cake hat. Sure thing. Yeah, I've heard of that drink before. Totally have. So, oh, a Bloody Mary and a screwdriver mixed together? I don't think this will work, but let's see. I guess this will have to do for him. Enjoy. Well, add your secret ingredient yourself then, you little freak. This bar doesn't prohibit people from bringing in their own things. There are plenty of additives that you can put in your drinks. However, I'm a bit too lazy to run out and grab them all. P.S. The sheriff is poison? But he can't be saying the sheriff is poison. I don't know, I can't make out his drunk speech. I'm gonna guess that the chef is not actually going to cook anything. Where did he even take Remy to? Did he try to spike him or something? Chef, where are you hiding at? I may have to get a wrench and a welder and break into the kitchen myself. So let's see, Mr. K-Cat is drunk, the captain is tasering people, there's a changeling above medbay, the captain is a changeling, and there's a wizard on board. Gotta send out a little, advertising for the bar while I'm out. Free non-alcoholic drinks in the bar. All the sugary sweetness you need to get through the awful day. Tons of violence in the brig, apparently. There's just a lot of stuff going on. Wow. A ton of cockroaches. Where did they crawl out of the burritos? Yeah, did the cockroaches hatch and just crawl out of the warm burritos as they were heated up or something? Holy crap. They've taken over medbay. And a Borg is trying to seal things up. Great. It's probably sealing up a changeling in there. You know what? Forget it. I'm not even gonna bother trying to get through that half of the station. The cockroaches can have it. Janitor with bug bombs to medbay. Something in there. I've never seen such a huge infestation. You may as well just kick back and relax to the music, folks. It's gonna be a long shift here. Get yourself some tea and a nice cigar. and just enjoy the shift. If the captain does happen to be a changeling, I want them to bring his body to the bar, so that we can reprocess it into Captain Changeling Burgers. We can't really let anything go to waste out here in space, because hey, it could be another week or two, or who knows how long before we get resupplied. If something happens to the quartermasters, that is. Nothing goes to waste on the station. Not even the test monkeys, the lab monkeys. Yeah, the cockroaches arrived in the shipment of the burritos. We should probably stop stocking those things. The bar would be a lot more busy if the chef was actually cooking. People don't just want drinks, you know, they want food too. So the chief engineer is a murderer now? Maybe the captain passed his blood test and wasn't a changeling. Detective! I know you can't pass up a good drink. James Pratt steps up. And he makes it to two sips before his mouth starts to pucker up. So sour, your eyes might cross forever. Right there, Detective. So you gonna drink all of them? Holy crap. I'll make something really strong for the Detective, though. We'll make another one of those special drinks, not with cider. I think this was the K-Cat special or something. There we go. Blood red. Go for it. This isn't a no-smoking bar. Yeah, this isn't a no-smoking area, by any means. Cigars and tea. In fact, why don't I put some tea out there? Just some straight tea. Okay, this guy wants more. I know what we're gonna give him. He can have straight sugar. We're gonna get him really hyped up. Right there. Oh no, not orange juice. Did he already drink all the eggnog too? And he pisses in the cup. Yeah, well, I'm not gonna serve that to any of my customers. Even I have standards, you know. Okay, that's my bottle of tea. I'm not sure he's drinking these ones with the sugar in them. They come out basically clear anyways, so it's so hard to tell. I guess we'll have a shot of vodka instead of bourbon. I'm not serving pee, okay. I think he pissed in it and then drank it too. What's up? More drink? These are drinks. It's not empty. Even if it looks like it. What is sugar? I'm pretty sure it's a complex hydrocarbon is what's in there. I'm not going to tell them straight up that it's just pure sugar. Yeah, see that? Is sugar. And for some reason, glass does not always show up over here. Whenever you throw it and break it on something. Oh, cool, I can actually put stuff in the eggnog bottle. Is this one empty? Okay. Damn it! I'm gonna get him so hyper, maybe he'll throw himself out in an airlock.
Send him wither. Send him wither. Die.
Okay, Cat, I already sold your recipe. I can pretty much retire now from the money I've made from that. Yep. Hate me all you want, Mr. K-Cat. The double Bloody Mary screwdriver is now my recipe. I think this is the last drink I'm gonna serve for a bit. This guy needs to just let some of these, chemicals actually start taking effect, I think. Hey, if you're gonna break my glasses, quit losing my glass shards. I don't care if you break them. And finish those other two glasses in front of you. Those are the pure sugar glasses that I want him to drink. I wish that I could make corn syrup, or even high fructose corn syrup, and pour that into glasses. See, another glass, another no shard. There's something in the bar that just eats glass shards. Good. I'm glad that he hates us. I'm not gonna serve him any more drinks. Actually, yeah, I will. We'll have to make him something super special when he comes back. In fact, since I'm pretty sure he will be back. Hey, at least I got a glass shard out of that. Let's start mixing this up now. We'll have a little bit of Bojack's in here. Of course. We'll have 30 units of it. That is way more than enough. And how about some rum? I think that should just be about full. There we go. You bastard. It's just a damn shame the chef disappeared. He puts his ID on the table. Interesting. Is he finally gonna kill himself? You're cut off. No more drinks for you. You're getting too unruly. He screams. Don't throw him over here. Damn it. Drunks are not allowed behind the bar. No drunks behind the damn bar. That's the rule in here. We don't serve droids. We don't allow people to get back behind here. If I had a shotgun, I'd shoot them. Just for trespassing. And the shuttle has already been called. And is he... So he's gonna try to break in here. Nope. Yeah, I'm not falling for it again, buddy. Yay. Here, you can just drink here. You can just stay there. Stay in this room and just drink yourself silly. Yep, now he's in paradise and he can drink to his heart's content. Did I really already have a drink mixed in that one? Oh yeah, I think that was the special one. It's up to you if you want to fix the TV or not. Nobody actually watches it. There is a TV back there. You can watch things on it if you are incredibly bored or just want to see what's going on. I've never actually bothered to fix it, so I don't know what happens if you do supposedly fix it. It turns into security cameras, apparently. Interesting. Yay. Is he screaming in there? What are you screaming for? You okay in there, naked drunk dude? Yep, he's perfectly fine. He can raid the alcohol cabinet all he wants. My most loyal customer upgraded to VIP status. Did the shuttle get sent back? No. It's gonna be a really short round. We'll have to try to make sure he escapes with us. I only wish I had some moonshine to give him. Get one last round of drinks going on here. See if we can get anyone to show up, and we'll actually get them drunk this time. Let's see, vodka. Should have done this the other way. So let's see, vodka and orange juice. And then, yep, gonna keep using K-Cat's recipe, even though I don't know the secret ingredient. This is close enough. This is a generic brand. The K-Cat special. I just don't know any other alcoholic drinks besides the screwdriver and the Bloody Mary. Okay. We'll make one more of these, and then we're going to make a face pucker special. I think we'll even enjoy this one. We've earned it. So let's see, triple citrus, lemonade, got some half and half, a little bit more lemon juice, and this is my special here. It tastes like there might be triple citrus, half and half lemon juice in this. The barman can take a sip of anything and tell what's in it, which is incredibly, it can be incredibly useful. Actually, I'm lying. It's not useful at all. It's just neat. It'll probably never, ever actually save your life. You want to go to the escape shuttle? Is that K-Cat? There's your special. Better drink it, Mr. K-Cat. Yeah, you coming, James? He's yelling, "Why shuttle?" He doesn't have a clue as to what's going on. Once it gets down to about 1 minute until the shuttle arrives, I'm probably just gonna take off. Start heading down that way. Because for all I know, the escape arm could be boarded up, blocked up, and I need to get a plan to survive and make my way off this station. You come in, drunkard? So I'm getting ready to leave. Hey, some gloves. I might as well take them. What else do we got? If there were an oxygen tank, I would take that. A cigarette. We'll take a smoke for the road. We've got our drink. We've got our smokes. What I need is a way to light this thing. If I could find Mr. K-Cat and knock him out, I could use his hat. Something tells me he won't willfully part with it. Yeehaw. Hey, and I think somebody did bring a bug bomb. Looks like most of them were killed and... Oh, poor James, puking and passing out. Come on. Never leave your best customers behind. There are cockroaches everywhere, holy crap. The station is filthy. Still didn't find any way to light this. Hang on. That guy might have a gun. There's got to be a welding tool or an igniter somewhere around here. There's a welder. Okay. balaclava, probably pronouncing that wrong, whatever. And Jay, the power goes out, but whatever, you've got a, no, my drink, pipe bomb, holy crap. I just saw it land right next to my drink. No, where is... James, get down here. You can't die. I gotta have somebody to serve drinks to. Aw, oh, crap. I have to put my cigarette out, too. It knocked him into critical. If we can get him onto the escape shuttle before he dies, there should be an emergency health kit on there. Yes! He's gonna make it. Don't you dare die on me. No. No! James! Come back! You bastard. It's the cockroaches is what it is. I can't get to them because they keep pushing me out of the way. Ah, well. Rest in peace, James. You're dead. Can't save you from that. You're drunk and stumbling. Oh, goody. And another bomb. Must survive another 2 minutes. Good lord. I don't know how the hell I survived that blast. See, I'm guessing these people are dead. Adele Lenny. Severely injured and burned. Not unconscious. Slightly injured. Mr. K-Cat, severely, we all survived amazingly. I'm going to just rush towards the medical kit. Manly Hooker shows up on scene. I am gonna heal myself. Let's see, a healing patch. It's probably all I need. Ah, cool. Some tricord, too. I don't trust really standing around anyone right now. Damn cockroaches, you killed my best customer! Oh, goody. I might actually suffocate here. Unless I can breathe inside the sleeper. I think I can. Oh. All in a day's work for nanotracing. So who will be the first to drop dead? This guy here? Manly Hooker? He's gotta suffocate out soon. There he goes. Roger Wilco tries to jump in. He can have it. I'll probably survive. He needs the oxygen now. Oh, one hell of a round, even for being as short as it was. Let's go get something to eat, shall we? I'm starving. And since we didn't have a chef that whole round, well... You saw how it goes. Traitors, at least you tried. I have no idea what actually happened with all of you. Dance with the jukebox and the boogie bots. This is our reward here. Oh yeah. I'll see you guys next shift. We've earned some rest.
You wanna put a banging donk on it?